I want to welcome you to Devos today. I'm very excited about this. Every day this week, I'm going to be speaking on a trait of success. Each day, different things that are very important that you can do very well in this life. And I want to let you know that God wants you to do well, even though we face trials and tribulation. Okay, so the idea of what we have this week is this. I want you to prepare today so you are not repairing tomorrow. But let's prepare. Now, I would like to take you first to Psalms chapter 1, verse 1. It says, now, blessed is the man that walketh not. He does not walk in the counsel of the ungodly. Meaning, you don't sit around and tell your non-Christian friends your problems. You're not asking them for advice. Nor does he stand in the way of sinners, nor sitteth in the seat of the scornful. Now, what that means is you're not fellowshipping with them. You're not hanging out with them. Now, I'll never, ever understand that if you're a Christian, why you want to be around and hang around with non-Christian people. You know, you're going to be like the people in which you hang around, and God knows that, so he says you'll be blessed if you don't do this. You say, now, Pastor, are you going to be sharing with us the secrets of success? Hey, do you know what the secret of success is? Are you ready? There is no secret, but it's this. Now, let's look down here in verse 2 of Psalms 1. It says, but his delights are in the law of the Lord, and that's the word of God. And in his law, in the word of God, he meditates day and night. Now, that's why you're with me for Devos here today. Now, you might be starting the day with me or ending the day with me, but I really want to encourage you every day to get alone with God and get into his word, maybe memorize his word, hide it away in your heart. And I want you to see here what God says he's going to do for you. This is going to put you on the cutting edge of being successful. Verse 3, he says, now, if you do that, you're going to be like the tree that's planted by the rivers of water, and it bringeth forth its fruit in its season. You know, there's seasons of life. There's good seasons, there's bad seasons. So now, so he says, in his season. So not every season is going to be successful. His leaf shall also not wither, and whatsoever he doeth shall prosper. Okay, so if I separate from the world, I go to church, I meet with God on a daily basis, I'm meditating on the word of God, I'm spending time alone in prayer with God, he is going to bless everything I do. And notice in there, it says, whatever you do, it is going to prosper. Now, I can't put inside of you the desire nor the will to want to do great things. But God will do that if you spend time with him and you obey him. You know, the devil's worst nightmare is that you're going to wake up. Now, let's go over to Joshua chapter 18. Now, here they are. They're getting ready to go into Promised Land. And the Israelites, just like us, are getting a little lazy. Joshua said unto the children of Israel, how long are you going to slack? I like it. Are you a slacker? Are you a slacker? He goes, how long are you going to slack to go and possess the land, which the Lord, the God of your fathers, has given unto you? Now, notice here, he already gave it to them, but they don't have it yet. Did you see that? Did you know there's things out there that God wants you to get? He already has plotted it. He has planned it. He has prepared great things for you for the future. But you're not going to get it unless you have the will and the desire, and you're walking with God to go to possess it. Now, I want to encourage you, starting this week out, I want you to think, what is it God wants me to do? I want you to seize the hour and to say, upon this day, this is it. As you pray, I'm going to go after that thing. It will be better for me and my family that I can honor and glorify God. That's the biggest part of this. Okay, so this is what I want you to do is you go into prayer. I want you to pray with faith. I want you to be bold. And if you're bold in your prayer and you believe, the Bible tells us just that the mighty forces of heaven, they are going to come to your aid.